In this video, I'll share some basic hamster knowledge to start you off with keeping hamsters. Syrian hamsters are solitary animals. Around 4 to 8 weeks of age, they can become aggressive or territorial with other hamsters around when they're housed together. This can be a stressful situation for your hamster that you can easily avoid by just keeping your hamsters separate or, if you only have one hamster, solitary. It's important to find the perfect hamster wheel because your hamster is going to spend a lot of time running on this in the night. Some hamsters will run up to 5 miles on it in just one night. It's important to buy the right size wheel. To start off, I recommend buying an 8-inch wheel because it'll fit most hammies. But if you see your hamster's back arching when they're running, you'll need to upgrade your wheel to a bigger size. If your hamster's back is arched for about 5 miles a night, it could experience back pain, deformities, or arthritis. Since hamsters are prey animals, they'll try to hide any weaknesses so they're not targeted by predators. Hamsters are nocturnal animals, meaning they'll usually be awake in the night. This can be good for people who are at school or work all day. A hamster is going to spend a large amount of its lifetime inside its cage, so it's important to find the right one. A great cage is buying the IKEA D-Tuff, which costs about $50 and is extremely large. Another great option is buying a bin cage because they come in a variety of appropriate sizes for your hamster. You can easily design it yourself, and there's plenty of YouTube tutorials to make these. In many places, a 360 square inch cage is considered the recommended cage size, but your hamster will be spending most of its nights there, so it's best to go for a larger cage. I also recommend going with a barless cage because in my experience, it's very hard to stop or prevent bar chewing. It's important to provide your hamster with chew toys for their ever-growing teeth. These are just some donut DIY chew toys that I made. In your hamster's cage, there should be about 3 or more inches of substrate, or in other words, bedding. Which ones are the best? Well, first let's rule out the unsafe kinds. You should never buy no-name beddings, or non-kiln-dried pine, or cedar. The cedar can cause toxic fumes that can cause liver and respiratory problems in your furry little guy. Packaging of your bedding, you'll see if it's any of those unsafe kinds. The most popular bedding is the Carefresh paper-based bedding. Your hamster will need material to make their bed. Paper towel is ideal. Cotton or fluffy bedding is often advertised as hamster nesting material, however it's not safe. The strings inside the material can get entangled in your hamster's teeth, around lips, and stuck in their cheek pouches. It's also non-digestible. Some better alternatives are clean paper towels and toilet paper. So that is it for this video. I hope you liked it, had fun watching it, and learned something new about hamsters, or just loved watching those cute trouble clips. So go ahead and press that subscribe button, and bye guys!